welcome to girlanduck.com. I'm Jen Storer, children's author and chief inspirationist here at girlanduck.com. It's Monday morning, but only just. It's been a very big weekend here at Girl and Duck. We opened our new membership site, our new duck pond, and it's been a wild ride, and it's been incredibly exciting. And we have all these enthusiastic, amazing people in there. And yesterday, at 2 o'clock on Sunday, we had an online launch party in here, so hence the leftovers in the background there. And also, I apologise for this being a bit slow this morning because I'm a little bit slow off the mark. As I sort of come down and, you know, have that sort of post-party, you know, slump to work through. But truly, it has been so amazing to open this new membership site. It is so gorgeous. If you don't know anything about the duck pond, hop over to the website and have a look. Just go to girlandduck.com and you'll see the duck pond in the... I'm predicting that you might be watching this on Insta or somewhere where the links aren't immediate rather than YouTube. So yeah, so go over to girlandduck.com, have a look at the duck pond and you'll see what's going on in there. And it's not too late to join. The cart's still open until Wednesday night. So if you're sort of sitting on the fence and thinking, oh, should I? Yes, you should. You should absolutely hop in. If you're interested in children's literature, if you're interested in creating it and being involved in the community, then it's a no-brainer. Like, seriously, it's just such a fresh, shiny, beautiful new space. This morning we roll out our first challenges. We're having weekly illustration challenges and weekly writing challenges. And our beautiful community host is looking after all that for me and rolling out all these gorgeous challenges, and people are introducing themselves and, you know, getting to know each other in a much more intimate way than in the other group, where it started to get so big that it was a little bit unwieldy. So I needed to put some more structure around it and curate it more closely, because I didn't want anyone to feel that they were stuck, you know, with their wheels spinning in the mud. And I was feeling that was what was happening with the big group. It was starting to get a little bit, you know, a bit same old, same old. And so I restructured it, reimagined it, and had this sort of massive big spring clean, and the branding's all different. And it's just beautiful. So please, if you are thinking about joining us, don't miss out, especially at this time when you can join and be a founding member. You can take advantage of the low cost, really low cost entry. It's $15 a month or $150 a year. And you get masterclasses with all these amazing authors and illustrators. You get weekly challenges. You just get this amazing community to support you. There's interviews in there. We kick off already with an interview with the amazing Katie Chappell from The Good Ship Illustration. So there's just all this sort of stuff going on there, and it's so exciting. So that's what's happening in the duck pond. So go to girlandduck.com and click the duck pond and have a look. And as I said, we are still open until Wednesday night for this intake. So it's not too late if you're watching this on Monday or indeed Tuesday. Okay, so let's go back to why I'm here today. So this is my 20 tips series. And all these tips are taken from my little book, See Me Jump, 20 Things I've Learned About Writing Books for Children. And of course, in the book, these tips are expanded upon. But this is just sort of, this series is just a taster and just to give you some insight and some help along the way. Now, in this part of the book, we are looking more closely at picture books. All right. But even if you're writing anything for children, there's a lot of overlap. So I suggest that you keep watching it, you keep enjoying the series. So today's tip. I have to admit that today's tip is kind of probably out of all of them, it's the most subjective. All right. So, but it's still a really, really important tip. And having worked as a children's editor, and having seen hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of unsolicited manuscripts, I feel that I can say this tip quite categorically. And it's tip number 12. And it is no teaching or preaching. Okay? No teaching or preaching. Now, up front, I will say, if you are drawn to writing a picture book that is sensitive and complex and deals with complex, deep issues, go right ahead. I'm not saying avoid complex and deep issues, but what I am saying is please never be condescending. Never sweep into the children's literature market thinking that you have something important to say and placing yourself above your audience, above your intended reader. It comes through so strongly, and nothing will put a publisher off more quickly, or an editor, or anyone who's reading it for that matter, than a condescending adult knows best voice. And in fact, the more sensitive the material that you're working with, the more acutely aware of your voice you must be. And if you don't really know what I'm talking about in terms of voice, go back to tip one, okay, and have a read of that. Because this is what we see a lot in children's publishing. We see people who have something very important to say and they believe that they can just say it. And they're not working on the actual real, the subtleties. When you're writing for children, it's really important to write at their level. And that takes a lot of practice. Okay. So don't come to this teaching and preaching. Come to it with some humility. All right. And then you will start to be, you'll get yourself into a position where you can share what's important to you. And you can share it and make an impact rather than, you know, putting your readers and your buyers and your everybody who's going to be involved in the book, putting them on the back foot straight away. As Dr. Seuss said, a person is a person no matter how little. All right? So keep that in mind. No teaching or preaching, and keep an eye on the voice when you're writing for kids. All right? That's tip number 12. I'll see you back in here next week for tip number 13. And don't forget, again, if you want to join the duck pond, if you want to get in on at the ground level, and it's loads of fun, and take advantage of this this opening special, the founding member special, then get on over to girlandduck.com, click on the duck pond, read all about it, and hopefully I'll see you in there. All right, I've got to go now because I have to go to the post office. We had a raffle yesterday in the party, and we had three people win Girl and Duck journals. So I've got to scuttle off down to the post office now and post those. Heavens knows where they'll go. Times are tricky with the post office, but hopefully they'll get to their destination eventually. All right, I'll see you back here next week. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.